Hey guys, right here I have a 2012 Volkswagen Beetle 2.0 TSI. And today I'm gonna make a startup and full vehicle tour video of it, show you the features inside and out.
The 2012 Beetle was introduced in 2011 and it was the successor to the Volkswagen new Beetle, which itself is a successor to the original Volkswagen Beetle known as the Type 1 that was introduced way back in 1938 and went all the way into production till the year 2003. The new Beetle's production ran from 1997 till 2011. The 2012 Beetle is longer in both length and wheelbase and wider, but it is shorter in height when compared to the new Beetle. The 2.0 TSI Beetle in Malaysia arrives in a sportline trim, which brings several options to the car itself. These options will be mentioned later, while for now, the exterior color of the car is known as Oryx White, which is classified as a special paint by VW, and the interior gets black leather seats.
So, here's the key. Let's go ahead and start it up first. If you press and hold on the unlock button, both front windows as well as the sunroof will open simultaneously. And to close all of them back, just press and hold on the lock button. Also, once you press on the unlock button, both front windows will dip down a little bit to clear for height. Frameless doors. Quite a nice leather steering wheel with minor sport grips on the sides, with a flat bottom as well as three-spoke design. This car comes with a 6-speed direct shift gearbox, otherwise known as DSG. Essentially what it is that it's an automated manual transmission with two sets of clutches. Clutch number 1 controls the odd gears, that's gears 1, 3 and 5, and clutch number 2 controls gears 2, 4 and 6. DSG allows for smoother shifts as well as less lag between shift times. You also have sport mode, as well as Tiptronic manual shifting via the plus and minus down here. And if you put the car in reverse, your parking sensor diagram will show up on the radio display. It's also known as the optical parking system. You can also manually activate this display just by pressing the button right there. DSG also eliminates the need of a torque converter for a conventional automatic transmission, as well as a clutch pedal of a conventional manual transmission. Alright, so let's go ahead and turn on the hazards. Lights, front and rear fog lights. Both front windows are automatic. And let's take a look at the engine. LED indicators on the side mirrors. The side mirror is also in this black housing.
The Sportline trim provides this car with 18-inch twister alloy rims and red brake calipers. The tyres on this particular Beetle are Hankook Ventus Prime 2, 235-45 R18 tyres, and the rims are also finished in this combo of polished silver and gloss black. The front of this car can never be mistaken for something else. It features the signature Beetle look with round headlights and a bulbous front end. It might be less curvy than the previous Beetles with straighter and edgier lines, but it still retains a front end that is not that far off from the design of both the original Beetle and the new Beetle. The VW badge is large, and like always, it is located right in the center of the front end. For the front, what the 2-liter gains over the 1.2, which is the only other Beetle model sold in Malaysia, and that one is in design trim, are auto-leveling by xenon headlights with LED daytime running lights, while the front parking sensors and front fog lights with fixed bending lights are common between the two models. The LEDs are not flashing around like that, it's just a trick of the camera. The 2-liter TSI Beetle obviously has a 2-liter engine. The engine that we have right here in question is a part of VW Group's EA888 series. This unit is a turbocharged inline 4 with dual overhead cams, 16 valves, direct injection, and variable valve timing. This unit produces 197 horsepower at 5100 RPM and 280 Nm of torque from 1700 to 5000 RPM. This car can go from 0 to 100 km an hour in 7.5 seconds and achieve a top speed of 223 km an hour. This car has a fuel tank of approximately 55 liters and a combined fuel consumption of 7.7 liters per 100 km. The car's carbon dioxide emissions rating is 179 grams per kilometer, and the car is front-wheel drive. The rear also gets some differences compared to its cheaper 1.2 sibling. There are dual chrome exhaust pipes and a rear spoiler in two-tone, body coloured on the bottom, while gloss black up top. Common to both models are rear parking sensors and a single rear fog light located on the bottom right-hand corner of the rear bumper. In terms of mechanicals, the 2-liter gains a 4-link rear suspension and the XDS extended electronic differential lock system. All these changes over the 1.2 is brought about because of the Sportline trim.
Speaker, storage area, window controls, mirror controls, your central locking buttons.
And because of the Sportline trim, instead of color-coded dashboard and door panels to match the exterior color of the car, it gets a carbon fiber look instead.
Storage area.
As part of the Sportline trim, the car also gets aluminium pedals.
The driver's seat in this car is fully manual. This is for your seat height, your seat position, your seat back, as well as your lumbar control. To fold the front seats to gain access to the back, just pull this lever. Alright, so let's go ahead and see how she revs. Right here, you have your climatronic dual zone automatic climate control system, fan speed in the middle, automatic, off, sync means, like it's showing right now, if it's turned on, both sides will be controlled by the driver, but if you turn it off, each side will have individual controls. Temperature for the driver, temperature for the passenger, front and rear defrost, maximum and air conditioning, heated seats for the driver and front passenger, your different modes and recirculation. You can also have the option of having your climate control display on the radio display. This car comes with the RCD510 head unit. On the main screen right here, you have your 6 customizable stations, your list of available stations, and you can further have more customizable stations in this menu. There's a total of up to 42 customizable stations. Your radio extras and your manual tuning. To tune, just twist this knob.
You can also press the left and the right arrows on the screen itself to tune between your different radio stations.
Your FM AM. Your media options such as your CD, SD card, USB auxiliary, mute, as well as your system setup. You have your radio setup, media setup, your system setup. You can set your language in this menu, traffic information, as well as your display setup. Your sound system settings such as your treble, bass, middle, balance and fader. Power folding mirrors. The mirrors are also heated. Steering wheel audio controls. Volume to switch between your different tracks or radio stations. Mute. your indicator and cruise control, wiper controls, and if I've not mentioned just now, you do have paddle shifters on the steering wheel to work with your Tiptronic system. The set of up, down, left, right, OK, and return button on the right spoke controls your multi-information display in the instrument cluster. Up and down controls between your different sub-menus, while left and right controls between your different main menus. Right now we have distance traveled, range, average fuel consumption, instant fuel consumption, elapsed time, speed warning display, coolant temperature, oil temperature, your digital speedometer, average speed, and the total distance traveled for the car, basically your mileage, which it shows 155 kilometers. Your audio menu, your settings, language, multifunction display data, your time, units, your service setting, and that's it for this menu. Then back to the multifunction display. The steering wheel in this car is tilt and telescopic. You adjust it using this lever right here. And in the center of the dashboard, you have a small little cutout for storage. It also comes with this ribbed area, so things won't easily fall out. Down here, you have a small little storage area with the same ribbed area as the storage area right up top, your auxiliary port.
You also get a power outlet right next to the gear lever.
Couple of cup holders, storage area in the center with your center armrest. It is adjustable. And you also have small little storage areas right here. Auto dimming, rear view mirror,
your panoramic sunroof.
It is automatic. And you can twist the knob to different positions to your own choice, depending on how much you want the sunroof opened. You also have a shade for the sunroof. Alright, so I guess that's it for the startup. We can turn it off right now. And continue with the rest of the tour.
The rear hatch can now be opened from the exterior itself just by pressing on the rear VW badge, and this was a feature that was missing from the new Beetle, where in that model you needed to press a button inside the cabin. As usual, you can also open the rear hatch from the key fob itself. Boot space in the 2012 Beetle is definitely much better than the new Beetle, since there was an increase from 209 litres in the latter to 310 litres in the former. That represents a 101 litres increase. However, if you still want more boot space in the 2012 Beetle, the rear seats can be folded down and the cargo cover can be removed to reveal 951 litres of boot space. The shape of the boot is also of a much better design, while the opening is much larger to improve loading and unloading. Under the boot floor, you have your spare tyre, toolkit and tyre jack. Both the left and right sides of the boot comes with hooks to keep small items from running around and a light to the right side to illuminate the area.
Front passenger seat is fully manual as well, with your lumbar, seat back, seat height, as well as your seat position. But if you climb into the rear seats, unless you're probably less than, I would say, 5'7" or 1.7 meters, you would fit fine. But if you're more than those measurements, you probably feel a bit claustrophobic. But you do have storage pockets on the front seat backs, single cup holder, as well as a 12-volt power outlet, straps to help you get out, or if you just want to hold it like that, storage area, speaker, but with the sunroof, it does light up the car quite nicely. To fold down the rear seats, just pull on this lever. And you also get child seat anchor points on the rear seats themselves. As a nod to the original Beetle, you do have what's called the Beetle box, if I'm not wrong, which is basically a storage area. You do have a secondary glove box down below. And if you notice this port right here, there's a cable that connects to this port that gives you your USB cable. Quite a nicely sized glove box as well. Alright, so let's start it up with the door closed. Alright, so that's it for the startup and full vehicle tour video of this 2012 Volkswagen Beetle 2.0 TSI. Thanks for watching and goodbye.